Got him. Ooh, bites. Oh, oh, come on, baby. Small as. Oh, oh, come on. You can do it. Oh, oh, on. Here we go. Damn, son. It's been a long time since we got a fish in Windang. I'm guessing whiting. Oh no. Oh, it's the baby brim, and he got fouled. Oh, tarwine, I think. Tarwine. Oh yeah, mate. Relax. I got you. All right. Okay. First little guy of the weekend. Ugh. Nice and shiny. Healthy. There's a few in there. Oh, they're just a bit small. So I might jump down there. Change up my rig and yeah. All right, I've switched over to a whiting hook or a long shank, whichever you want to call it, and two bean sinkers. We'll see what we get. Now the tide's supposed to be coming in, but in Windang, for some reason, this is always flowing out. So it's actually a real pain in the ass to fish here, because you flick it in here, within 10 seconds, your line's way out over there somewhere. Bait gone and escape the tiny hook, so they're either clever little bastards or they're just that small. Oh, I think I'm on. Gotcha. There you go. Whiting hook, and you get a whiting. Oh my God, stay still, bro. Relax. Yeah. Small little whiting. Nice and clean and shiny though, and not slimy for a change. Although he did just poo on me. see how low I can get without getting dirty, eh? All right, there's definitely some little whiting here. Oh, straight in, straight on. Got him. Feels a little bit bigger, unless I've... Oh yeah, no, she's bigger. Straight up. All right, back you go, buddy. I don't know if you can see him or not, but he's real cruisily swimming away. Straight back down to the sands. Nice, all right. Good, good, good. All right, well, it's been a fun little morning. Tide's at a standstill now, so I'm gonna get some food, maybe come back. I'm gonna try back out on those rocks over there. It's usually a good spot on the incoming tide from memory, because on the out, as soon as the current kicks up, it just pulls your line straight into the rocks and you're in within 10 seconds. So we'll try on the way in and we'll see how it goes. All right, had a little snack, I'm back. The tide isn't really doing what I want it to, and the float keeps getting carried in quite quickly, even with the change in tide. So I've actually rigged up a home brand Paternoster rig with the only heavy sinker I have. So fingers crossed, I don't get a snag and lose it. We'll see how this one goes. Certainly soars with the big sinkers. All right, move spots again. Fingers crossed. Straight away. Love it. Take the hook, man. Take the hook. Am I on? On. Love it. Only small, maybe. Oh, it's a flounder. I don't know if any of that actually got on the camera, but I caught the biggest flounder I've ever seen. I think it's like 40 odd centimeters. GoPro decided to stop working and it got off and fell in the water. So you just don't get to see that. My apologies. Let's see if we can get another one though. They're getting bites already, thank God. Oh, 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 is that on? That's on, yeah! Nah, got off. What a bitch. What a bitch. And wrapped me too. What a bitch. Little flatty. Oh, finally, here we go. Something, something, something. Like a brim for me. Nope. Oh, maybe. Tie one. Relax, 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 relax. All right. I can't tell. He's too small. It could be a brim or a tie one. Pretty sure it's a tie one. With a forehead like that.
Alright, well, that was somewhat of an adventure today. Some tiny ones in the morning, a little bit bigger in the afternoon. In the case of the drops, he's a good team to actually grab any fish to take any photos until the end. Super disappointed I lost that big ass flounder too. But all out of bait, stink like bait. See you next time.